Now I'm going to ask you to lay down so I can inspect your abdomen. All right, upon inspection, your abdomen looks smooth with no presence of striae, lesions, or any scars of any sort. Now I'm going to listen to your abdomen and your bowel sounds. So I did notice that your bowel sounds were a bit hyperactive, which is probably just due to your diarrhea. Next, I'm going to palpate your abdomen. So when I push down, just let me know if that causes any pain, okay? All right, does that
ow.
Hurt?
Ow.
Does that one hurt right there?
Ow.
All right. So as noted, your abdomen is very tender. I noticed that it was very distended, but I did not feel any masses or anything to be concerned about. All right. Next, I'm going to check your pulses. So first, I'm going to check your radial pulse for 30 seconds. Alright, now I'm going to assess your dorsalis pedis pulse on top of your foot. All right, now I'm going to assess your posterior tibial pulse. So all your pulses look good. Next, I'm going to check for any presence of edema on either the lower part or the upper part of your body by pressing into your skin. All right, I did not see any edema, either pitting or non-pitting, so you're totally good with that. Next, can I have you stand up so I can assess your range of motion? All right, so first, can I have you bend your neck to the left and the right? And then can I have you bend your neck forward and then backward? And then can I have you bend your back backward and then down and touch your toes? And then can I have you bend your whole body to the right and to the left? And then can I have you swing your arm out and then back in? And then the same thing with the other arm. And then can I have you swing your arm back behind your neck like this? And then other arm. And then back behind your body. Same thing with the other arm. And then can I have you bring your hand up to your face like this? And then back down. And then same thing with the other one. And then can you place your palms up like this and then turn them over? Good. And then separate your fingers, make a fist, and then can you make a waving motion with your hand? All right, good. Now can I have you lay down so I can assess the range of motion for the lower part of your body? So first, can you lift your leg up into the air? All right, and then the other leg. And then can you bring your heel up to your knee? All right, good, now for the other one. And then can you rotate your hip outward? And then for the other one. And then can you rotate it inward? Good, and now for the other one. And then can you move your leg away from your body? And then bring it back in. The same thing for the other one. Can you bring your knee up towards your face? All right, good job. Now about the other one. And then now for this, I'm gonna have you actually lay on your stomach. And then can you bend your leg and bring it up towards your back? All right, now for the other leg. All right, now I'm gonna have you come back onto laying on your back. And then can I have you flex your feet and then point them? And then rotate them in, rotate them out, and then move them side to side. All right, good. Your range of motion all seems normal. Now I'm going to assess the strength of your feet in your lower body. So I'm going to push force against your feet on the bottom, and then you need to push back against me. All right, good. Now can I have you sit up so I can assess the strength of your upper body? You're just going to shrug your shoulders while I push down on them. All right, so everything in your strength looks normal. Now for the last part of the head to toe assessment, I'm just gonna have you walk in a straight line, heel to toe, so I can assess your gait and balance. All right, everything with your gait and balance looks fine, and I will see you next time. Thank you. Mm-hmm.